Hello friends, welcome to the Mind Touch Tech YouTube channel. My name is Prince and this is our 25th JavaScript lecture. And in this lecture, we will study about that how to apply styling to the HTML elements by the use of the JavaScript. That is how to apply styling to the div tag, how to apply styling to the buttons that you make in the HTML. That is, if you click on a particular button, then the background color of the body will be changed. Like if you click on a blue button, then the background color of the body will be blue. If you click on the red button, then the background color of the body will be red, friends. This is very good and very important lecture of the JavaScript. So let us start, friends. So friends, first of all, what I want to create a div tag in which I want to apply the styling by the use of the JavaScript. So let us create a div tag here, that is the div tag and then the close of the div tag. Now let us give the ID to that div tag, that is the ID is equals to div1 friends, that's what it. And also let us add the content in that div tag so that it will be visible to us. So the content, suppose, hey, I am div, that's the content. Control plus S, open that on double clicking. Now you can see here that a message has been shown, that is, hey, I am div tag. So it is a div tag for us. Now what I want to apply the styling to that div tag by the use of the JavaScript. So let us see how to apply the styling. So go to coding and again we have to write here the script tag and then the close of the script tag. Why script tag? Because we are going to write the JavaScript code here, friends. So first of all, what I have to do, I have to access that ID, that is the div1, to the JavaScript. So to access that ID, I have to use here the document dot get element by ID. Get element by ID, that's what. And then braces of these. And in the double quotes, I have to give here the name of the ID that I want to access. So I want to access that div1 named ID. So I have to give here the name of the ID, that is the div1, friends. That's what it. And then semicolon. Now let us put that whole in a variable, friends. So we have to write here the variable, that is the variable, and then the name of the variable, suppose my message, and then equal to. So I have put that in a variable. So now what I want, friends, I want to change the color of that text. That is, this is black. Now I want that this text will be red, friends. So to do like that, what I have to do, I have to use here, that is like that. First of all, I have to write here the variable name, that is the my message. And the dot, and after that I have to use here the style, that is the style, and after that again dot, and after that color, and equal to, and in double quotes I have to write the value of the color, that is red, friends, and then semicolon, friends. So what I did here, friends, first of all I have to access the variable and the dot and then the style, because we are going to styling the text. So and then again dot and then the color, that and then equal to, and then the value of the color, that is the red, friends. This is both there. Now control plus S, control plus R, you can see here that the its color is now red, friends. This is about that, friends. Okay, now what I want, friends, I want to add the background color of that text. So to apply the background color, what I have to do, I again have to write here the variable name, that is the my message, and the dot, and then again style, and then dot, and then the background color, because we want background color now. So we have to write here the background and then color. Notice here color C must be capital, friends, and then equal to, and in double quotes let's give the value of the background color, that is the, suppose I want black, friends, and then semicolon. Control plus S, control plus R, you can see here that its background color is now black, friends. Now what I want, friends, I want a border in that, friends. So to apply the border here, what I have to do, I again have to write here the my message and the dot, and then again style and the dot, and then border. That is the border, because we want to set the border to that. And then equal to, and in double quote we have to write here the value of the border. Suppose 7 pixel, and then space, and the color of the border, that is suppose solid blue. That's about it. And then semicolon, friends. That's about it. Control plus S, control plus R. Now you can see that its border is now blue, friends, and it is 7 pixel, friends. Okay, and this is that. Now suppose change the color of that red to white, because it is not looking good. So I have to write here the white, friends. That's about it. Control S, control plus R. Now you can see that. This is the div tag that I have styled, friends. Now what I want, friends, I want to apply the events to that div tag, friends. Like by hovering my mouse there, then this style will come, friends, by hovering my mouse. Let us see how. This is important, friends. So to apply the event, so first of all, what I have to do, I have to apply the event to the div tag, friends. So I have to use here the suppose event, that is the onmouseover. on mouse over, and then equal to, and in the double quotes I have to give here the name of the function, so that we have to put that coding into a function, the style coding into a function for us, so that we can access that function here. Now let us apply here the function, that is the function, and then the name of the function, suppose my div, and then the braces, this type of braces, and after that the curly braces. Okay, now what I have to do, I have to put that last is put that curly braces in the last of that coding, like their friends, this is about their friends. Okay, so what I did here, friends, I have put that coding into a function named myDifference. So what I just have to do, I have to call that myDiff named function into that myOver event, friends. So I have to call here, that is the myDiff, and then the braces and the semicolon, friends. So friends, I have called that myDiff named function to that myOver event, that is the myDifference. That's about it. Now Control plus S. And then now Control plus R. Now if I over my mouse there, then this style will come there, like that. That friends, that's about it. Again Control plus R, and again if I over my mouse there, then this style will come from. That's about it, friends. That's. You can also apply the on click event here, friends. That is the on click event. Control S, Control plus R. Now if I drag my mouse there, then nothing is happening. But when I click here, then this style will come, friends. So this is the difference, friends. Okay, this is about that. Now the most important concept, friends, I want to create the two buttons. Okay, that is the one is blue button and one is red button, friends. Now when I click on the blue button, then the background color of the whole body will be blue, and when I click on the red button, then the background color of the whole body will be red, friends. So let us see how to create that, friends. So first of all, let us remove that whole coding, like that coding, remove that, and also remove that div tag. So first of all, what I have to do, I have to create the two buttons. Let us create the two button, that is the input type is equals to button, and then the value of the button, suppose blue, that's about it, blue, and then the that, and again create the second button, that is the again the input type is equals to button, and then the value of the button, suppose red, is equals to red press. That's about it. Control plus S, Control plus R. You can see here that I have two buttons. One is blue and the one is red, friends. Now if I click on that, then nothing is happening, friends. So now what I want, when I click on the blue button, the background color of the whole body will be blue, and when I click on the red button, then the background color of the whole body will be red, friends. So let us see how to apply that, friends. So first of all, what I have to do, friends, I have to make the two function, one for the blue and one for the red, friends. So let us apply the make the first function, that is the function, and then the name of the function, suppose blue, and then the braces, and after that the curly braces, friends. Now in these curly braces, I have to use here the coding, I have to write here, that is the document dot body dot style dot background color. Notice here the C must be capital, friends, and then equal to, and then the value of the background color, suppose blue, here should be blue, okay, blue, and then semicolon, friends. This is about that. Now again create the second function, that is the function, name of the function, that is the red, and after that the curly this type of braces, after that the curly braces, and in these curly braces I again have to write here the document dot body dot style dot background color is equals to, that is the red, friend. This is about it, friends. Now what I have to do, friends, I have to call that function into that event, friends. So I have to use here the onClick event, that is the onClick, and in that what I have to do, I have to call that function, that is the blue, friends. So I have to write here the blue, and then this type of braces, and then semicolon, and also what I have to do, I have to also apply here the onClick event, that is the onClick, and after that I have to call here the red named function, that is the red function, that's body, and then semicolon, friends. So what I did for here, friends, I have called that blue named function here, and I also have called that red named function here, friends, and also I have done here the coding of that, that is the background color should be blue, friends. Control plus S, Control plus R. Now if I click on the blue button, that's about, now you can see here the background color of the body is blue. Now if I click on the red button, now you can see here that the background color of the body is red, friends. So you can create so many buttons that you what you want in that, friends, to see the background color, friends. So this is the concept of that, friends. Okay, so I think it is enough for today. So if you like my video, then you can subscribe my channel, share my channel, also press the bell icon for the latest notifications. So thank you, take care, bye bye.